discussed about hemorrhage and shock. As first, we discussed about hemorrhage, its definition, causes, classification, and method, mechanism of hemostasis, and how to achieve hemostasis like mechanical, chemical, and thermal. So now we are, last we finished with mechanical, now we are continuing with the chemical methods of hemostasis. So, microfibrillar collagen. The collagen derived from bovine skin causes shorter activation in addition to that plate activation. Instead of its advantage of causing deeper swelling, it tends to reduce the plate on normal individuals and inhibiting in thrombocytopenia. So its absorption time is 3 months. Fibrin rope is a biological adhesive which contains thrombin, fibrinogen and factor 8 and aprotidin. Another is Triptrix and Astrigis. It precipitates protein and arrests bleeding. Commonly uses Triptrix and Astrigis are monsoon solution containing ferrous sulfate and tannic acid. Thrombin and gelatin points are now widely used. Alkylic acid, this is available in powder form in special 5G packages. It placed over the bleeding sites and perfectly filling is formed over the bleeding site. This film covers the capillaries and stabilizes the blood flow in place. Another is natural collagen sponge. This is a white sponge material, non-allergenic and fully absorbable. It stimulates the platelets, aggregation therapy and enhances hemostasis. It activates coagulation factor 9 and 4, 11 and 4, 11 and 20. It is prepared in patients who are susceptible for hemorrhage and after dental surgery. Fibrin sponge. Fibrin sponge is non-antigenic and is obtained from bovine material. It is chemically treated to avoid allergic reaction. It is applied on the bleeding site, especially in the post-extraction socket. It stimulates the coagulation, thereby forming a normal clot. This also addresses temporary blood clots now in the fibrosis. The fibrin sponge is fully absorbed by the patient within 4 to 6 weeks. Bone wax. The bone wax is a sterilized, non-absorbed mix of wax. Bone wax consists of 7 parts by 8 of wax and from this taken from white beads, wax of paraffin wax of iron isopropane instead of carbonic acid and 2 parts of olive oil and 1 part of phenol. It is white and available as a solid rectangular plate weighing 2.5 grams. It is integrated in terms of weight from the bone or from the shifted disc of the bone. So usually when we do doing the surgery, bleeding from the bone marrow is more. So for stopping the bleeding from the bone marrow, we usually use the bone wax. The bone wax is softened with the finger to a desirable consistency and then applied over the bleeding site. Its hemostasis mechanism through mechanical absorption of the oxygen carrying contained in the bleeding vessels. The frequently used may lead to the formation of wax diaphragma. So it is a foreign body. If you use frequently, you can dose the foreign body diaphragma and wax diaphragma. The osteen is a new water-soluble bone hemostatic agent. And new bone hemostatic agent made of water-soluble alkaline oxide copolymers. It has no incidence of adverse response in the cortical defect site, medullary cavity or the surrounding tissue. Use of the conventional bone wax causes foreign body response including fibrous tissue infiltration by macrophages, giant cells and lymphocytes the site of the body defects. And bone wax also displaces the bone marrow and interferes with the bone in growth into the defect. Osteen, a water-soluble bone hemostatic agent, has shown of adverse tissue response, no adverse tissue response, or the interference of the bone healing seen with the use of bone wax. So, advantage of this the compared with the bone wax, it does not produce any adverse tissue response or interference with the bone healing, but bone wax shows a foreign body reaction and they interfere with the bone growth into the defects. So thermal agents comes to the third is thermal. First initially mechanical, chemical, now it's thermal agents. Thermal agents are cutting instruments have been modified using thermal agents in order to achieve hemostasis during surgery. The delivery of heat or cold during the cutting can be done by electric current or laser beam or diffuse migration or radio frequency energy. The thermal agents coagulate and seize the blood vessels and they can't achieve hemostasis and a blood vessel fluid out during surgery. So what is the advantage of a thermal agents? This mainly during the surgery it produces bloodless fluid during the surgery. If you use scalpel, there will be bleeding. But if you use a thermal agents like electro cautery, it used to cut the tissues, it bone was brittle. So, and also this is the surgery, vascular, which is like a hemangioma, that can potentially cause life threatening intraoperative bleeding. So, in if you use careful to remove it in the vascular lesion, like hemangioma, you can expect life threatening intraoperative bleeding, but by using the thermal agents, we can reduce the risk. So, electrobotulinum surgical diathermy. The electrobotulinum is a surgical technique that depends on the thermal and electrical character. A high frequency current is applied to a specific area of the body for the removal of unwanted tissue, coagulation, or to create a surgical incision. The frequency of current used are in the range of 1 to 3 MHz. Cleaner, safer, and more efficient than any of the other techniques. So, we usually do this surgery using electrobotulinum for the dissection to reduce the bleeding. So, it is a cleaner, safer, and more efficient than many of the other techniques. The instrument used to perform this procedure is also known as electrobotulinum. The properties of surgical diathermy is that diathermy uses high frequency electrical current to produce coagulation. It can be also used to cut as well as the cold press the tissue. And so, means cold pressing means like during the blood vessels, we cold press, after we can cut the tissues, like for during the dissections. It can be used to cut as well as cold press the tissue. The electrical frequency used by diathermy is in the range of 3 kHz to 3 MHz. In this procedure, the electrical conductivity of the human body is the used that the patient body forms the part of electrical circuit and the electrical current used there and usually has no effect on the muscles. So, in this procedure, we have already know that our body can pass the current. So, it uses the human body in the circuit and it forms a part of electrical circuit and the electric current usually has no effect on the muscles. Types of diathermy are monopolar or bipolar. Monopolar diathermy consists of high frequency AC generator, over 20,000 Hz, a regulator, foot control, active electrode, and indifferent electrode. High frequency AC generates alternating current at a very high frequency. Regulator controls the current generated by the AC, and foot control, the passage of current is controlled by the foot control, and active electrode is the tip of the instrument, and an indifferent electrode is applied at the place of the patient. So, for completing the circuit in the body, you usually place, this is the indifferent electrode, you place the indifferent electrode in the body to complete the circuit. And this is the, where we cut the tissue, we are using the monopolar. This is the tip that is called the active electrode. Using the active electrode, we cut the tissue, and for completing the circuit, we place this in our body, like an indifferent electrode to complete the circuit. When the foot control is pressed, the current passes between the instrument tip and the active electrode and the indifferent electrode. As the surface area of the instrument is less than that of indifferent electrode, the electric plate or high condensity is produced from the active electrode, which is resulting locally speaking another part of the instrument and minimal heat is produced at the indifferent electrode. So, how it's working is there is a two electrodes are there, like you remember, like when placing two electrodes, we place a wire to pass the current. Similarly, one electrode is placed in the body, that is indifferent electrode, and one is the active electrode. From the active electrode, tip is very small, and indifferent electrode, the size is very big. So, the heat produced in the indifferent electrode will be less, but the heat produced in active electrode is more. So, using that, we can cut the tissue. Bipolar diathermy consists of low power AC generator. For monopolar, it's high, it's low power AC generator, in like bipolar. This also has a foot control and two electrodes compared to an instrument. Here, there is no indifferent electrode in a bipolar. It's a both are active electrodes only. Two electrodes compared to an instrument like a process. When the foot control is pressed, a low power AC is generated and passed to the tube which is the same instrument. When the tips are both together, a circuit is created producing a localized current. As the current produces a form of a small power, the instrument is used only for coagulation and control current. So, monopolar we usually use for cutting and coagulation, but bipolar we usually use for coagulation only. For coagulation means it can coagulate the tissue so that stops the bleeding, especially the blood vessels. Advantages: diathermy reduces the risk of far depletion of anesthetic gases. The effect produced by diathermy depends on the current intensity and waveform used there. By changing the intensity of current, various functions are possible. Like coiac is a small building process and capillaries can be coagulated in the form of the system. So usually when we are doing the surgery, when we cut the vessels, this bleeding can happen. So to coagulate the tissue, we usually we can coagulate small blood vessels, we can use the diathermy, and cutting the soft tissue with the use of capillaries can be used incisive using diathermy. So we can cut the soft tissue using diathermy, and pulverization, the destruction of tissue using the cover is known as pulverization, especially in skin pores and moles. In the face, like a leg laser, we can burn the tissues, like moles in the face, that is called pulverization. So, using the diathermy, we can do the three procedures. Before changing the currents, we can coagulate or cutting the tissue during surgery, or pulverization means burn the tissue, especially in moles and skin pores. So, small growth like papilloma and leukoplakia can be removed using diathermy. Risk and caution can interfere with the pacemaker function. So, risk is using cauteries, pacemaker is there. Then it can interfere with the pacemaker, as it can occur with the thick cord and other medical instruments or implants, and surgical band can occur in split basis skin preparation, and diaphragm bands can occur under indifferent electrode space improperly applied. So, if we indifferent electrode is placed improperly, then it can cause burn, and indifferent electrode should not be placed over near body, this should not be placed, and operator should use a rubber or food based on an accident band. And you should not be using their isolated plaster particles for nerve, though it can cause the nerve damage. So cryosurgery. So cryosurgery is the process of rapidly freezing tissues by exposing it to an intensely low temperature, usually from containing liquid nitrogen residues. While it is not an ideal coagulation method, cryosurgery just limits the extent of blood loss with extensive uptake surgery. So effect of rapid freezing is increasing the concentration of intracellular fluids, reduction in intracellular water, cell membrane damage, formation of intracellular ice crystals, and formation of extracellular crystals. Technique of application is frame technique, probe technique, and forceps technique. And general clinical uses are sorrow keratosis, seborrheic keratosis, wire warts, skin tags, sarcomas, lentiginous macules, acid elevates, and erosive lichen planus. There are also reports of successful treatment of basal cell carcinoma of skin. Time carcinoma and other aggressive growth issues, cryosurgery is not useful to control active bleeding because since the properties of laser are more beneficial and user friendly, laser has replaced cryosurgery in many surgical applications. So, apparatus consists of a container in which the pressure is the refrigerant media or stored as a liquid gases. The refrigerant media generally used as liquid nitrogen at a temperature of minus 195 degrees Celsius. The other refrigerants are carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide and freon, which can reach a temperature of minus 22 minus 10 degrees Celsius. But we usually use liquid nitrogen. A probe is connected to the container through a tube, and this probe is applied on the region of the abnormal tissue. The time required for the destruction of the tissue by the probe depends upon the temperature